Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we're gonna check out Moonlighter, which is an action RPG by Digital Sun Games, which came out in May last year. And well, let's just try and jump into this and see what it's all about. You can play it with a gamepad or with your keyboard, and from what I know, you don't even need your mouse, so let's see how this is gonna go. Let's just say new game. And yep, the first save slot should be fine. Okay, so we have new game or new game plus. Well, I haven't played this before at all, so it's just gonna be a new game. It can be changed later through the game options, so we can change the difficulty later on if it gets too hard. Okay, so normal for players who want to focus on the story. Hard, recommended. Original difficulty level created by the developers. Recommended for most players, and very hard for players who want a combat challenge. Well, I think we're just gonna go for the recommended. I do like to focus on the story, but from what I've seen from reviews and stuff, it doesn't seem like there's that, like, is that heavy on the story side. So let's just try and go for hard. And hopefully it's not gonna take too long to load this in. But this is definitely gonna be different. Having to use a keyboard for everything. Okay, among the stars of the night, there is a land as old as imagination. One night, mazes full of extraordinary treasures and deadly creatures appeared in this land. They call them the dungeons, strange, ever-changing ruins of unknown lands. Soon, a village of the slightly curious took root near the dungeons. This they named Rainoka. Among the settlers, two groups shined brightest, heroes and merchants, glory and riches. But the dungeons proved too dangerous. They were soon closed as too many lives were lost in their depths. Life became hard for the town, especially for the young owner of the oldest shop, Will of Moonlighter, long dreaming of opening the mysterious fifth door of the dungeons. Aha, so of course Will is who we are gonna be playing as. Okay, let's see Jay to continue. So let's go see what's gonna happen. Loading. Aha, so this is Will. And can I control you? Nope, not yet. Okay, oh, now we have control. Oh, nice. Okay, so WASD to walk around, and then it's like, okay, we can't use any combat thing yet. Okay, inventory, nope, doesn't seem like we can do anything with that yet either. Can't even get it to go away. But 0 out of 20. Okay, well, let's just try and follow this arrow key and or arrow sign and see what happens. Aha. Okay, we can roll. Can I do anything else? What's this down here? Ooh. Okay, let's just see. Is there anything? It doesn't seem like these things give me anything, though. Ooh, there's also some books or something over here. It doesn't seem like I can interact with them, though. Nope. Okay, let's just continue then. See how this is gonna go. Ooh. Okay. Aha, so we can jump roll over these things. Oh boy. That was not good. Okay, we're gonna have to practice this. Wee, man, there we go, we did it. Nice. Okay, so now what? It still only gives me like my little roll in the top there. Can I do anything? J and K should be for combat. Okay, well, let's try and go over to you. Oh! Then he just killed me. Okay, and set should be for changing weapons, but that doesn't really seem to work. Okay, we can also just roll past him. I guess that's just what we need to do. Yeah, roll over. I just figured that out. Okay. Hi, Zoe, and hi, Wamjäger. Whoop. There we go. Aha. So, and I, how do I, oh, J and E, so, okay. Oh, these are like, Can I do anything with these guys? Nice. Oh, cool. Okay, what does E do? Do is to interact with stuff, I guess. Okay, well, we're just gonna continue. If we can figure this out. Do I have to... How do I... do anything with this chest? Okay. No, okay, it's also just an attack. Oh man, this is a strange way of teaching things. Okay, Jay seems to work a lot better on this. Aha, nice. Ooh. Oh, look at that. Okay, so how do I take things? Oh, Jay, grab, hold, grab, stack. L back, I close, set, quick move, all. Okay, let's just say set. And C is quick move. Aha. Okay. I have no idea what all that stuff was, but we got something. Can I open this now, too? Yes. Nice. Okay, so we have to kill the mobs before we can loot anything. Can we get anything from these? Yes, we get health potions, so let's just do this. Ooh, boy. Okay. Oh, no. Okay. Wow. Come on. I'm hitting J. Let's do something. So, K, what does K does? Man, this is hard. Oh, did you kick me out? Aw, you kicked me out and I probably lost all my stuff. But that might have been intended. It might be part of the story. What a sorry looking kid. All alone now. Rest for a bit, Will. I have you now. It was probably intended that we're supposed to die, just to kind of show us what happens when we die, that we lose all our stuff. And I don't know if the music and stuff is too loud, but I can't actually... turn it down any further because it's actually at the lowest. Even as a mere child, barely able to walk, you were curious of the dungeons. There is no doubt you carry the same obsession as old Pete. Morning, boy. Did our little merchant bite off more than he could manage? Yeah, I think he did. Well, listen to me. The hard truth is this. You are the last of your family, the only one left to run Moonlighter. You can't keep pushing yourself like this. Risking your life on this fifth door nonsense is foolish. Just leave it. Find some artifacts, then use your pendant to get out of the dungeon. And for Crater's sake, stop using that broom of yours, you daft boy. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. It's mine from back in the day. Use it. I have little need for it now. Oh, look at that. It looks like we get a shield and a sword. Now then, get up. You are wasting light. Can't have you neglect the shop all day. Let's see if I can get through your hard heads some of the tricks that I picked up from your grandfather so many, many years ago. Oh, hi, John. How are you this evening? Let's see. Okay, so now we have our little shop. Successfully selling your merchandise takes knowledge of two things. You must know an item's value as well as its demand. Come now, open the shop up and allow the customers in. Okay, so from what I've seen, you have to kind of choose some prices, and then over time you're just gonna learn what how much people will pay for them. Okay, if I just say J, that's to sell. Well, I have to wait for people to come in, I guess. There we go. Hold to open shop. Aha. So now we have some people coming in here. Can I actually, do I have anything in my inventory? I can't open my inventory. What if I say, oh, okay. Someone wanted to sell something or buy something nice. Did you see that? Best expression you can hope for. The item wasn't too expensive for them and not so cheap for you to lose profit. Be sure to pay attention to your customers' expressions. That's how your grandfather always knew if his prices were fair. Okay. I didn't actually notice their expression at all. Let's see. Oh no, he didn't like that. I don't think I need to tell you how that item was obviously overpriced. Lesson learned. Finally, be careful of selling a popular item too much. If you flood the market, you'll have to offer cheaper prices on your wares. Point is, charge higher when something is in high demand and in low supply. Take out your merchant notebook. It should hold all the information you have gathered on discovered wares and artifacts. Okay, that's good to know. Why did my inventory suddenly go down to 5 out of 20 instead of 17? You have kept up with your merchant notebook, right? No, not really. I'm good, thank you. Oh, you've been playing Atlas. What do you think about it? I have it, a friend of mine gave it to me for Christmas, but I haven't actually checked it out yet because there were so many problems with the servers, so I kind of felt like holding off a little bit. You have kept up with your merchant notebook, right? I keep saying that. Okay, let's say I. And then what? E. Ooh, okay, so crystallized energy. Selling and reaction. So at 100. Oh, that's handy, so I don't have to remember it myself. So 170 was too expensive and 100 was then they're happy. Oh, okay, and popularity neutral. Searching through a golem crystallizes upon its destruction. Could we harness this power somehow? Ooh, okay. How do I... Okay, set doesn't do anything. See. Okay, I guess I only have one page because set and C doesn't do anything at all. If I say L, that goes back. Would seem the sun has fallen for the day. I best head off. You'll pick up more on your own. Restoring this shop to its full glory? That responsibility falls to you, not I. It's in your blood, Will. Make us proud. In the meantime, why don't you try out that new sword of yours? Dungeons are more perilous, I guess. I have no idea how to say that word. At night, but one can always find better artifacts. Just don't dive too far and use that pendant, boy. Okay. And we're saving. Go on now. These weary bones of mine must rest. Okay. Well, I kind of wanted to check this out again. So what do we have? We have rich jelly. We have a broken sword. We have white stone, gold runes, and foundry rests. Whatever that is. Then we have a training short sword. Looks like it comes with a shield too, though. And then we have our broom spear. And with set, we can change which one we use. So let's just keep with the sword. That's probably a good idea. Then we have 100 health, 25 damage, 10 defense, and 185 something. I'm not sure what the bottom one is. Okay. And then If we go in here, are you gonna let me? Oh, there we go. Now we can actually do something. So, merchant, 512,000. Wow. Well, we have 300. Yep. So something makes them. Yeah, we don't know what the prices are gonna be. Okay, what is this? Then we have merchant, golem, forest, desert, and tech. I guess it's the type of item we are selling or something like that. And then we have page up and page down. Where in the world are those keys on my keyboard? I never use page up and page down for anything. Game. Do I even have a page? Oh, there. Okay. Okay, I'm not sure they are even gonna work. I might have to change those controls later on. Anyway, let's just try and see. What then? Are we supposed to kind of sleep or something to pass the night? You got a new sword, don't you? Head on off to the dungeon, boy. Okay, so I guess we just have to go and explore. Interesting. Yeah, they have, but it's early access, so they're working on it. It's definitely early access, so it's probably gonna take a while before they sort everything out. Dungeons. Okay. Ooh, can't go that way. Ooh, hello, who are you? Rainoka may not be as prosperous as it used to be, but many still visit to pick up a souvenir from the Golem Dungeon, possibly even one from the closed dungeons if we're lucky. Interesting. So can I do anything with these boxes over here? Oh, come on. No, doesn't really seem like it. Who are you? Looks like that is still... You're just saying the same as the other person. So is that it for the story? Okay, I can't really get in here. It looks like there would be a door right there, but... Nope, it won't let me. Interesting. My kind of game though, like building games. Oh yeah. I can imagine there's a lot of options when it comes to building. In Atlas. Oh, no. Okay, I can't do anything here. Just kind of trying to... So are you all gonna say the same thing? No! Okay, well... I saw you in the Golem Dungeon earlier. Found anything mysterious? Nope. Have you found any new culture artifacts in the dungeons, Will? I always found it fascinating how all the items you find in the dungeons appear to be from entirely different civilizations with unique cultures. That's interesting indeed. Oh, can I break this? Oh, I can. Nice. Oh, I can break them. I guess maybe it's because the other one had like a metal frame or something. That's why I couldn't do it. Masa, my son, when I find you... Oh, Will, have you seen Masa around by chance? Nope, sorry, I haven't. Will, can we play tag next time I stop by your shop? Well, sure we can. Okay, well, I think that's more or less the town, I guess. Doesn't seem like we can really go into any of these buildings, so... Okay, so there's dungeons this way, but there was also dungeons in the other direction. Let's just try and go this way. I'm still gonna go and get myself killed. Ooh. Looked like it dropped something, but maybe it didn't. Yeah, see, this one we can't... We can't seem to break that one. Apparently it's too hard for our sword, but we can drop anything that is, or break anything that's out of wood, it looks like. Golem dungeon. Dungeon available to merchants and heroes. Interesting. Is there anything in the other direction? Forest dungeon. Dungeon available to heroes, not recommended for merchants. Okay, I'm not a hero yet, so I guess we have to... do something heroic before we get access to the forest dungeon. Do, 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 do. There we go. Okay, so we have a map. Okay. That didn't show me much. Just shows where we are, but I guess we haven't seen anything else yet, so let's just try and go through here. Oh boy. I'm so used to using my mouse for combat, so this is a little unusual, having to use my keyboard. There we go, but we did it. We did it. Yes, we did. Nice. Okay, let's continue. Okay. Okay, so far it's not too bad when I actually focus a little bit. Ouch. Oh, okay, yes, like I said, focus. Nice. Okay, we are getting some goodies. Can I actually see what I've gotten so far? Okay, 8 out of 20, but for some reason you can't actually open your inventory while you're in here, so I have no idea what I'm getting. That's interesting. Can I open it now? Nope. Still can't open it. It's kind of a little peculiar, so you have no real idea of whether or not you have picked anything up that's worth going back for. Okay, I can't seem to do anything with this. Oh, crap. Of course I did that. Can I do anything with this stuff? Oh, hello. To a person of hopefully far better luck than I, my time is short. I took injury from the strange creature across the room. There's a creature? My pendant, all but shattered from the scuffle. Check him out, though. I'd say I'd fared better than he. He caught me spying on him near the guardian's room. He dropped a couple items when he fled, one of which is this map? Diagram? Whatever it is, I was right. They called me crazy, said old Crazy Pete done gone lost his marbles. But I was right. Each guardian of a dungeon must possess a key of sorts. All of them linked to that giant locked door outside the dungeons, the fifth door of Rhinoka. Sadly, I won't be around to see the door open. To whoever found me up, I apologize for the smell, but the diagram should be around here somewhere. Please open the fifth door of Rhinoka. These dungeons are not what they seem. Okay. Oh, there we go. Okay. Big boss, gonna kill me. I supposed to let them all out. Now have to chase this weird creature that stole my stuff. Ah, big boss gonna be so upset with little me. I have no idea what's going on, guys. Okay. So, yep. We have to find the four keys to open the fifth door. I guess that's what it's telling me. And we got some stuff. So, okay, two coins and a pendant, five coins and a pendant and an L and then, I don't know what that means. Okay, two coins and five coins and hold L and then we leave the dungeon, I guess. So I need to have five gold coins to leave the dungeon or something? Or it cost me five to use it, I guess. Yeah, you can see in the bottom right corner, it's L. Oh, so we can't go anywhere else from here? Well, maybe it wants to teach me how to do this, so let's just try and hold L. Oh, nothing happened. Oh, I guess I didn't hold it long enough. So, escaped with pendant. We got a lot of little wood picks or something. And I'll go to town. Zero. Okay, we killed six mobs and then zero something. I don't know what the top one means. Okay, well, let's just go to town. What then? What then? Okay. Ah, we might get to hear more stuff now. I can't move. Ah, the young proprietor of Moonlighter has returned. You look intact, finally learned to use that pendant properly. It's about time, boy. What are you holding? Is that a chart of the dungeons? Where did you get this? You found old Pete? Dead. See, this is what happens when you chase what's behind that door. Leave it, Will. Just get the artifacts you need from the Golem Dungeon and look after Moonlighter. Now, I noticed some posts on the town board that may be of interest to you. Some shops want to move in, attempt to revitalize this town. Apparently, they need some startup capital first. Would be nice to see some new life in Reynoka. Nice indeed. Okay, so I have to find a board. Okay, I still can't move. I have to wait for him to... There we go. Okay, so that's what it was for. Aha. Have we talked to you? The people of Reynoka are so accustomed to culture artifacts from the dungeons. They have become a part of our daily lives, even a part of our food. Oh, you even eat them? Interesting. Okay, so investments, town, or in shops. So we can, if we choose the town, what do I have to press? Enter. Ooh, okay, Vulcan's Forge. Do you feel the dungeons are too hard? Tired of your old weapon, I can solve that if you bring me enough money and materials, a forge to be reckoned with. That's probably a good idea, but we need 500 gold for it. How did we end up with 100 gold? Didn't we have 300 and then we spent 500 to get out of the dungeon? I have no idea. The wooden hat. Is brute force getting you nowhere in the dungeons? Visit the wooden hat to find potions and enchantments for this and that. The retailer. Okay, 1500 gold. Tired of looking for items in the dungeons? Leave that job to others and come to the retailer. Okay, well, you'd probably say Le Retailier or something, if it's supposed to be French. Where you'll find the finest items in Reynoka. Because life's complicated enough. Then we have the hawker. As a hawker, I've traveled the world looking for techniques to create objects that can inspire people. Visit my cart to find objects that can make your shop look more interesting to visitors. Then we have the banker. Wow, 70,000 gold. Man, this is gonna take a while. Interested in making your money work for you. Trust your money in my hands and I'll make it grow before your eyes. Signed, the banker. That doesn't sound suspicious at all. Okay, what does E do? Shop upgrades. So, shop level 1. This shop expansion allows merchants to decorate it to please their customers as well as additional space for their items. Oh, okay, so there's like a cheap sale box, there's iron cash register, comfy bed, small chest. Oh, this is something I definitely am gonna need over time to store stuff. Okay, but that's... I guess that's just for my... that's for staff. Okay, what if we go back? Because it did say... What if I say the shop? I guess that's the shop upgrades, maybe? Yes. So that's the stuff that I can add to my own shop. So we need 8,000 to increase the shop level. And then we have all the stuff we can buy, which I guess we can already do now, or what? If we get the money, of course. Ooh, average sale box. And medium chest and big chest. Okay, there's all kinds of stuff we can do in here. Boy, Reynoka has seen better days when your grandpa first opened Moonlighter. People from all over the lands would come to visit the shop. The hustle and bustle was constant, but now... If you insist on diving deeper into the Golem Dungeon, please, Will, make sure to buy some better armor. You can bring a blacksmith to the town using the town board. Yeah, well, I need some money before I can do that, so... Let's just try and go in here. And how do I actually place anything? So... This is what I have in my bag. And this is... Okay, what is all this? Vine, Teethstone, Water Sphere, Iron Bar, Root. Thing is, I'm not quite sure exactly what. Ooh, okay, wish list. What is that about? I guess it's stuff I can put on my wish list. Okay, remove from wish list. Or maybe it's someone who can request it, I guess. And we have a calendar. And what is the last one? That's our notebook. Nice. So, oh yes. Okay, so this stuff in the top is the different dungeon. So, merchant, I'm not quite sure what that means. But this is the golem dungeon, of course. The forest, the desert, and the tech. Okay. Well, I am gonna have to check something, so let's just try and check this, and let's see, we go to controls, and for some reason it keeps going to controller, let's switch to keyboard, and where is it? Page up and page down, can I change these? Aha! So if we just use whatever is, okay, that's going to be 9 then, I might be a problem. Okay, I should probably choose something else. Okay, let's say this one, which is a completely different key on my keyboard than what it shows there. That's a confusing thing sometimes with this. And then we're going to use that one. And see if that's going to help us when we are in the game. So let's just try that again. And then we had, how did I get into that dot inventory? And then we had E. Okay, so let's see if I can actually go. Yep, there we go. And aha, now I have page up and page down working. Awesome. So we have white stone, piece of a container for preserving the properties of infused water. Fairly useless in its current form, but I could easily melt it down to craft something new. See, this is what I'm wondering, if I should keep some of all this stuff and sell instead of selling everything. I believe this to be the remains of an old foundry. If the golems are created, what created them? It has a small crack or two, but could still hold something beautifully crafted. Curious what it could have been used for. Ah. Okay, that's the only thing we have tried selling so far. What else do we have? Iron bar. Fairly basic, but the very cornerstone of any mid-tier equipment one may wish to craft. That's why I don't think I want to sell this off. But maybe I want to try and sell something. Well, root. Very useful in crafting of new bows. Teethstone and vine. Okay. Well, I guess we're just gonna try. So how do I place something? That's the question. So if I say J, and what do we want to try and sell? Let's try and sell two of these iron bars. Grab, hold, grab, stack. So if I just say C, quick place. We have two of them. Okay, and then let's try and sell some of these. And what else we're gonna try and sell? What is this? Gold runes, white stone, broken sword, rich jelly. And I choose how many I want to place. Okay, see. But how do I change the number? It doesn't seem like you can. What if I don't want to sell that many? And how do I remove things once I have sold it? Okay. Then I just end up here again, which is not really what I wanted. Oh, okay, I can go over there. And if I press C again, then I remove it. But what if I just only wanted to sell one of them? I have no idea. Okay, up, down, crystallized energy. Back, eye, close. Okay, what if we say J? Oh. Okay, then I hold it. But it doesn't change the size of the stack. Okay, well, we're just gonna try and sell those, I guess. And let's open the shop and see if anyone wants to buy anything. Yeah, oh right, he's still upset about that one, of course. That's not too good. Can I change that while they are doing stuff? I guess I can. But how do I change the prices? It didn't quite tell me that. Do you guys see anywhere where you can change the prices of things? Oh, there we go. Okay, I said, hey, hey. Okay, so enter and then... Okay, so you can't just write it, can you? Nope, that doesn't work. Okay, so we're gonna have to do it like this. Just use WASD for it. Or that would be W and S. Aha. There we go. Okay, so... Let's see what happens here. Now he might want to buy it because we changed the price. I forgot to put prices on the other stuff. Let's see. You gonna be happy? Yay! Now he's happy. Okay, let's just sell that to him. Cool. Got it. So. Okay, of course, we're gonna have to try and put some prices for this. So what would we say for iron? Oh, no, no. Clicked the wrong button. Let's try that again. And, okay, and... I have no idea what would you sell iron bars for. And I think, I don't know if they're gonna buy one at a time. Because it does say times two. Okay, I think that might be a little expensive. Let's say something like that. And, oh, nope. I keep doing that. And go over here. And what would you sell that for? I don't know. Let's say 25. And then we have this jelly thing. Okay. Let's say 50 or something. I'm just gonna have to see if they get upset with us or not. And I should place something else. What are we gonna sell? T-stone. Yep, let's do that. Quick place. And we're gonna put you. And then we're gonna sell it. Mm-hmm. So is this the type of game you guys would play? It's not something I have played much before, anything like this. Let's see. Nope. Okay, that was not good. Way too expensive for the iron. Anyone gonna check out anything else? But also, it's gonna take time though, because you're also gonna have to sit and see they don't like the prices. It's way too expensive. Oh man. Okay, I'm too greedy. Way too greedy. Yeah, it is kind of confusing, isn't it? I don't find it very intuitive. Well, you can figure it out, but still. It just feels a little hard sometimes. But okay, this was way too expensive. Then you can go in here and see... Why doesn't it actually show anything? It should show in here because we already had some complaining. Or being unhappy, so it's kind of strange that they're not showing it for any of them. Because it should show on the right hand side if they are expensive on or if they found it expensive or not. Because we already had some reactions to it, so I don't know why they're not doing that. Okay, let's try and... Oh, actually... Okay, 60 was too much, so let's try and put it down to, for instance, 30. And this one, let's put you down to 15. And this one, let's put you down to probably 25 or something. And this one, I'm gonna put you down to 20. And I still... Okay, can I right-click? Oh, I can. And then move it. Look at that. Ah, so that's how you do it. So you just press enter when you're on it to pick one up. And then you can move that out if you want to. Ah, that's cool. So that's how we split. Okay, let's see if they're more happy with the new prices. Might still be way too expensive. I have no idea. See, that was too expensive. It seemed... Oh, no. The iron is okay now. So that's good. It did say it was a little low. I don't feel like it went that much further down. But okay. They still don't like the price of the teeth stone, I think. Nope. And they don't like the price of the sticks. Okay, let's just try and go back. Man, you are gonna be spending a lot of time on this stuff. So, let's see if it updated. Where were we? This one, and... Okay. Oh. Gold runes hadn't. What a sphere. Iron bar. Okay, so 30. Oh, popularity low. So that's what the low meant. It's not actually that it was low, but it's not cheap enough. But it's cheap enough that you'll buy it, but they're not exactly happy about it. But it's interesting that they didn't register any of the other things we tried to sell, like the wheatstone. See, it doesn't say anything or root. Interesting. Well, I guess we're gonna have to... Okay, let's try this. Then we have to say enter. Can I put... Oh, another enter. Yes. Okay. Let's try that. And then we're gonna put them in here. And then it was 30. So it remembers the last price you have set them at. That's at least handy. So you don't have to sit and check out the prices every time. So let's try with 20. Yeah, but have they seen what they're trying to charge you for the stuff you need? Yeah, I wonder what they will be charging for it. There we go. Well, there are some handy things. Like the fact that it remembers the last price you had. So that is kind of handy. Okay, let's just try and bring this down again and see what they say this time. Ooh! Okay, now we're happy with the iron bar price. Yep. Oh, there we go. Sell. Okay, we made a little bit of money. Oh, what now? Oh, it's saving. So I guess it's a new day or something. Balance 10 something. Then we have crystallized energy times 100. And we sold 5 iron bars, so a total of 220. Nice. Well, we go in here now and say E. Then our I miss my mouse. See, now it's not updated. He was happy with the price, but it still hasn't updated for the iron bar. Isn't that strange? It seems a little buggy in that way. It doesn't haven't updated anything here either. Because it did update for... where is it? Yeah, this one. See, it has 170 that they're unhappy and 100 happy. So it should update when they're unhappy about something. I don't know why it doesn't do that. Seems like there's a bug with that or something. Okay, well, most of this we're gonna have to wait and see if they are gonna... be happy with the with the current prices, because they haven't checked it out. So what's the idea now? Well, we kind of need more stuff, don't we? I kind of need a place to store stuff. Your grandpa was a great friend of mine. You take after him in so many ways. His stubbornness definitely being one of them. Boy, Reinoka has seen better days. When your grandpa first opened Moonlighter, people from all over the lands would come to visit the shop. That's the same as he was saying before, I think. Have we talked to you? Yes, we have. Oh, you can't just skip it. I have to actually talk to them. Okay, well, we can go into... But I would kind of like to leave some stuff here, but... I don't think we can actually... make a chest yet. How much to make a chest? See, we need 4,000 to even be able to store anything. It's just if we go and we... die in the dungeon, then you actually lose some of the stuff you have on you. So, I am thinking... let's just go in here and I don't know. Let's take this one. There we go. Grab all of them and put you there. Can I actually put more there if I want to? No. Okay. Let's take... oh, no. Okay. Let's do it a difficult way. There we go. And put you there. Oh, no. Okay, I keep forgetting that I just need to use J. Okay, we can take all of these and put them there so we don't lose them. Because then, see, now we have all this stuff that we're gonna have to carry around with us. Which limits how much stuff we can get in the dungeon. But I guess we're just gonna have to do that. We don't have any chests anyway yet, do we? Oh, we do have a chest. Haha, nice. Good thing that I checked. So, let's just... well, we could just say set. There we go. Let's just store everything there. Nice. And what is this? Oh, that was this thing. So maybe it gets updated over time so you can see what you have actually unlocked. And what is this? Oh, we do have two chests already. Oh, nice. So we can store some stuff. So we don't have to put it for sale. Okay, well, at least we don't lose any of that stuff if we go into the dungeon. So let's just try and give it another go and see if we can actually get any further in that dungeon now. It doesn't seem like you get anything from these things. From breaking them. You can break them, but... Well, let's try and go in here. Because last time we couldn't progress any further, but I guess we can now. And yeah, he did say that we should get some armor and stuff, but we can't really get the blacksmith until we have like 4,000 gold, so... oh boy. Oh, roll, roll, roll. Ooh, boy. Oh, we made it. Okay, what is this place over here? Okay. That's interesting. Wow, we're taking damage. Oh, man. It's not very easy to move because if you're, like, trying to shoot fast because you easily get stuck. Can I get through any of this? Oh, no, not really. Oh, so I can't go and attack that thing. Okay, let's just go here then. Oh boy, we're almost dead. Yes. That's not good. Oh, we didn't really get much of anything. Nope, let's just try and play again. Not really worth it going back to town yet, is it? Do I have any? Oh, I do. I do. E is healing. It looks like. So let's remember that and try this again. Oh, but as you can see, it's kind of procedurally generated, so it looks different every time. Oh, come on. Beat it. Oh, no. Okay, there we go. Why do our tools keep disappearing? Chambers full of precious stone are left untouched, but rooms and chests holding our most basic tools keep vanishing. Okay, that's interesting. I don't know what this is. It's like a pool of water. Gosh, I'm curious. Is there anything in here? It doesn't seem like it. Huh. Interesting. Well, let's try and go here. Oh boy. Okay. Roly roly. Yep. There we go. Okay, I should be able to deal with you. And then... Oh wow. Because if you're just kind of hitting, then you can't roll at the same time. So it kind of blocks your roll. So if you just kind of spam clicking, that makes it really hard to roll away. Okay, this combat is going to take a little getting used to, I think. So let's see what we get. Okay, we got a little bit of goodies. What was it for kick move? C. Nope. Oh, set. Aha, we got some goodies. I'm not sure what those little icons mean, though, that are blinking. Artifact must be placed to the left or right of bag. Oh, right, there's all these special enchantments. I did read something about that. So, you can see it has to be placed in one of these places. And that means that... Oh, did I pick something up? I didn't mean to do that. Let's put you back up here. Oh, okay. Just put you there. But that means that sometimes it might replace another item. If you don't have any room in these sides of the bags, then apparently it might replace some of your other items or something. If you pick these up, or... You know, it can be an inventory juggle, because you try to pull these out and then you have to leave room here, or they might replace their neighbor, or there's all kind of special enchantments that affects your inventory. Oh boy, I'm stuck. Oh no. Oh, run. Oh, what is this? That's some kind of goo. Oh, roll. Okay. Oh no. Oh no. E. Oh, deal with these little dudesies, which is not going very... Oh, do I have to use my broom for those, maybe? I don't know. This is... Oh, I have no idea. But my sword didn't really seem to have much effect. Okay, so sometimes... See, okay, now it worked. Not quite sure what happened before. Maybe I was standing too close to them or something. Since it didn't seem like it had much effect on me. And I don't know if it has any use actually breaking these things. Do you have anything? Oh, I can break it. That was nice of me. Breaking a corpse. And this is probably the same as before. Yes. Oh, okay. Let's see. Oh boy. Okay. Oh, roll. Oh no, that's not good. I forgot there's a hole in the ground there. Okay. Ouch. Okay, E. Man, you take a lot of damage. I should probably have gone for an easier mode than this. Okay, let's see. So, what's special about you? Must be placed to the left or right of the bag. Must be placed to the left or right of the bag. That should not be a problem. But see, it automatically does that though, as long as you have room for it. Oh yes, they do. They hit very hard. Okay, you can't actually get out to me right now, but I probably want to kill you. I think you have to kill the mobs to progress, so... Oh, no. What are you doing? Oh, man. Okay. Come on. Let's see. Next up. Ooh, I wonder if this is the next level, because there's like 4 levels or something of each dungeon. This is one of the strange devices that creature dropped when he fled. This one's rich actually almost quite literally rich. For every item you place into this device, gold of some perceived value drops out. It's great if you need to use your pendant in a pinch. The device looks like a mirror, so I'm just gonna call it the mirror, keeping it simple. I do wonder though, where do the treasures dropped inside go, and am I getting the best deal here? Okay. So it's a way of selling stuff. Ah, yep, okay, I remember seeing something about that. You can do that to clear out your inventory a bit, for instance. Or to make sure that you actually get something for your items, in case you're gonna dive in deeper, but you also get only a fraction of what you would get if you sell it in town, so it's kind of a gamble. You can make sure you get something, because you can sell it, and then you get a little bit of gold, or you can risk it and risk losing it by going further, and then you might die and lose everything. So we are just gonna try and continue and see what's gonna happen here. So deal with you. Okay, let's take the little dude there first. Oh, it's hands. Oh, did it just die somehow? Why did he just die? Why did these just die? I don't know. That was strange. Oh, wow. Okay, but I got some items. Okay, what's the best way of dealing with you? I don't know. Okay, there we go. And then hit, and move. Oh, no, no. Okay. Aha. Come on. Yes. Nice, we did it. Awesome. Okay, I think that's everything in here. How much room do I actually have? I don't have, oh boy. Yeah, now I might end up losing all my stuff here because, oh, I fell in the, of course I did. Okay, roll. Keep them all at a distance and press E. Ooh, come on, you can do it. Okay. Okay, well, I can stand a little bit at an angle and then, or like a diagonal and shoot it. Or hit it. See, it seems to only be able to shoot to like left or to the sides, or what is it I'm trying to say? Vertically or horizontally, so if you're standing at a diagonal, then it can't hit you, it seems. Okay, so we have these guys. Do I have any more healing? No. Ooh, how did I get... I have to break some stuff with some healing items. Okay. Okay, you probably is the same thing. If we just stand a little bit at an angle. See, it doesn't go diagonally, it only goes horizontally or vertically. Haha! Yep, I'm onto them. Okay, so let's see what's special about these ones. Artifact remains hidden while currently in dungeon. Interesting. Destroys one artifact in direction shown upon returning to town. Okay, so I have to make sure there's nothing in this slot compared to where this thing is. So if we hold and pick it up, then I should be able to just put it there, and then it can't destroy anything, right? Because there's nothing below it in that slot. That's handy. Destroys one artifact curse in the direction shown when placed. Okay, so then it would be best to put it here, right? And remains hidden while currently in dungeon, so that means we can't see it or something, I guess. Place it there. Oh, so we just don't know what it is. Aha, until we get back to town. Oh, I didn't take all of them. Okay, let's just take the full stack and put you there. Oh, I can't. Huh? You can't stack to more than. Oh, then you just switch places. Oh, come on. Okay, that's strange. Now I can't put them back. I don't know what was up with that. Okay, but we are kind of getting full, guys. And we don't have any healing items, so I am thinking it might be a good idea to go home and empty everything out, even though I'd love to try and go deeper, but I think that might be a good idea to try and get some better armor and stuff before we do that. For now, we just want to get some stuff. Boom! And it spits us right out. Nice. Okay. So. Let's see. What do I have? We go in here. Okay, it's a water lamp. And that is hardened steel. And hardened steel. Nice. Can I not stack you with this? Yes, I can. And this. Okay, let's just put you down here. Then we have some iron. So I think this is for crafting, probably. We're gonna need some of that. We have a lot of like wood. But I think we need that for crafting too. So then pick you up. Aha. Uh-huh. What else did we get? We got vines. We got broken sword, which we could repair or melt down or something. So that is actually also something down here for crafting, I think. Oh, can I put you there? Yes, thank you. Water lamp, water sphere, glass lenses. No idea what they're for. Just kind of trying to decide what we might want to sell and what we don't want to sell. Well, we probably want to try and sell something of everything. Just trying to sort it out a little bit. We have crystallized energy. No idea what you're for. Oh, we got more iron bars. Okay, let's just put you there. And oh, then you pop. Ooh. Okay, so. Put these down here. Oh man, we got so much stuff here. Oh no, we have more of these. And what is this? Plant flesh. Okay. We have whetstone. I think we have some of that for sale. Let's keep some of it. We have some of this for sale too. Teeth stone. And we have some of this for sale. That seems to be easy to come by in these at least in the golem dungeon. What is this? Fabric. Might be something to use for an armor or something, I guess. And we have a water lamp. Okay. I know, kind of just spending time on sorting stuff. Let's see, what? So it seems like there's a lot of stuff we can still get in this dungeon. I'm not sure what that 3000 means. Oh, and where did my money go? Why do I suddenly only have 20 gold coins? I had like 300 and something, and now I only have 20 left. It doesn't cost that much to travel, does it? Using your pendant should only cost you 5 coins. So why do I only have 20 left again? That is so strange. I don't know what's up with that. Am I losing stuff just kind of randomly or what? And I still don't understand what these numbers mean. Like it says 3,000 there, 5,000 there, 16,000. This is so confusing. Okay, so gold runes. These gold runes create wonderful patterns upon the golems. Occasionally you can retrieve one intact after battle. Okay, it doesn't say anything about needing it for crafting. Stronger steel I've come across, perfect for crafting new equipment. That's what I was guessing. Sturdy but rough to the touch. I imagine some would want to use this in a creation of decorations for fabric. Okay, then there's the what? Okay, see, then it says 2050 right there. Why does it say... Oh, 250. Why does it say 250? Is there another one? No, and then it says chew down there. What about the water sphere? Okay, glass lenses. Glass shaped into a lens with the sole purpose of focusing magical energy. Very useful in the crafting of magical weapons. That would be awesome. Crystallized. Might be able to use it somewhere. Foundry breasts. White stone. Piece of container. Yes, water lamp. May a lamp not of flame, but of glowing water, heavier for sure, but more reliable in the long run. Okay, I'm not sure what that 250 means. And then 3000. Is that like the highest price you can sell them for something? So water lamp would go for 250 maybe? And the vine would be best sold for 2? So this is like the minimum price you would sell it for, and then it just gets more expensive moving up. So I am rather confused. I'm just trying to understand what that number means, but I think it actually means that if you have whatever this is right here, then you would sell it for like 3,000. So the higher up you are, the more expensive the item is, or the more gold you can sell it from. Or sell it for. But right now I kind of just want to know what all this stuff is. If it would be sold for something. But if that is the idea. Yeah, let's just see if we try to sell some of this. I don't think we have had people checking out all this stuff yet at these new prices. So let's see. Nope, you don't like the price of that. And... don't like that, no. Nope, okay. They think all the prices are too expensive. That's not good. Is there levels? Because I was thinking maybe the higher level you are, the higher the price of something. I don't think there's levels in that way. Or not levels. I don't think that affects the price. I think the price is constant for each item. You just have to find out what it is. That's why you have that notebook, so it will tell you if, well, their reaction tells you too. But they don't like the prices of any of this. So if we check what each of these items are in here. So if we go down here, then we have like gold runes. What do we have that we have tried to sell? See, then we're at 250. So I think if we sell the water lamp, we should probably set it to that price more or less. But here we're pretty far down. So we have the iron bar, which is too expensive at 30. Which means it needs to be sold for something cheaper than 30. Which I think, wasn't that what we did? But it never updated it. Now it's just popularity neutral. Then we have whetstone, so that has to be cheaper than iron bar. Root has to be cheaper. Teeth stone has to be cheaper. And wine is the cheapest, so it's actually the 4 cheapest items we have here. So if we go here, and then we say the vines, let's put them down to... put them to 2. Oh, I hadn't even set a price for them, but let's set them to 2 because I think that's what it should be. And let's set you to something like 7 maybe, and let's set you to, you for instance, 10. And you, I don't remember seeing this actually in the, let's check again. Okay, so if we go in here and we go all the way down. So, vine, teeth stone, root, and redstone. Where's the... They're not even here. Okay, so vine, teat, stone, root, and whetstone. Vine, teat, stone. So vine is the lowest. Teat, then this one should actually be... Oh, no. Let's just put you back there. Should be cheaper than the wood, I think. For them to be happy. But these ones... With the witch jelly is not actually part of the golem thing. So I'm not sure. Oh, here it says merchant. So it says 5 in the bottom. So they should probably be something like 5. Health potions. I guess all of this is something you can buy from a merchant, maybe. Since it's called merchant. Okay, so that means... Oh, so see? Happy now with the vines. Okay, if I go in here... And then we go down here, then this one should be 5 for them to be happy with it. So there we go. See? There we go. We sold these. And now we're selling the sticks. The roots. Okay, but I'm selling too many of them. So popularity is kind of going down. But see, now we're selling stuff. Yay! Okay, anyone wanna buy this last stuff here? See, now they're happy. Hehe. there we go. That's what happened and it didn't update. Yeah, it's kind of strange with that. Oh, hi, Libocab. I'm doing good. Just trying to figure out a strange game here. how are you doing tonight? So, let's see if it actually updated something now. Because it would be nice that it did. So, if we go down, vine... Oh, look at that. Yes, 2. Then it's happy. If you put it even lower, then they're going to be excited about it. But popularity is neutral. Teastone, 6. Neutral. Root is 7. So that's a little too high. That's interesting. So I probably have to put it down to like 6 or something. And redstone, we haven't actually tried. And this has to be a little lower than what it is. Okay, if we go and try, let's see, what do we have? Let's try and get these. There we go. And what else do we have? We want to try and sell another root for a different price. Let's take one of these whetstones, right? And try not to sell too much of things because then it's a problem suddenly. Because there's too much of it. So if we put you... Then right now it wants to set it at 1, but I think 1 is a little too low. Should be higher than the root, maybe, so... I'm just guessing, I'm not sure if I have figured this out at all. But if we say we set you to 8, then let's take the root, put that in there, and bring it down to 6. Then take the iron... Put them here. And 30 was too low. But they were kind of happy with 20, right? It just never updated. So let's just see if they're going to do it now. Okay. See if someone wants to buy something. Not good today. Feel horrible for some reason. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I hope you'll be feeling better tomorrow. It's like physically or psychologically. There's a lot of people who are actually you can press escape or enter to sell stuff instead of J, it turns out. There's a lot of people who are sick these days or sick lately. I've been struggling with a cough for like forever. Oh, I guess it's a new day. Balance, I'm not sure what that 12 means in the top, but okay, we sold some vines, we sold some roots, we sold some teeth stone, witch jelly, iron bone, redstone, nice, 197. So I'm at 217, but I still don't understand why I lost 300 gold when we left the dungeon. That is so strange. Don't really want to place anything, I just want to see if this has gotten updated. Ooh, let's see. Okay, so Ironbark. Yes. Okay, so 20 is actually very, very, then they're very, very happy. So 25 would probably be kind of the, you know, then they're okay, happy. And they're very happy about this one. Wow, they're still not too happy about the root. Even at 6. We sold them for 6 this time. Oh, now it updated. Look at that. The furthest to the right, number 10, or for 10, it's updated. I think there's just something with it that is slow in updating. T-stone and 2. So yeah, I think it is some kind of estimate that you can use these numbers to kind of get an idea of, you know, everything underneath this can be sold for less than 250. Just to give you a little bit of an area of, okay, how expensive should I set this? So if you want to sell fabric, we should start at 250 and go up or something like that. I think so anyway. Physical problems with my heart again. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I didn't know you had heart issues. Hope it's gonna pass soon. Actually, my mom has been having issues since last year. But that's with, I don't even know what you call that in English. I would say fluttering. I know what it's called in Danish, but it's kind of like her, I guess her heart rate or something, or the beating of her heart kind of doesn't keep a steady rhythm or something. So it kind of almost feels like she's getting a heart attack or something, but she isn't. It's just kind of very scary, but it's, yeah. It is not fun dealing with stuff like that. Okay, let's see. Why do you refer me to this guy? It had like a little exclamation sign, but... not enough money for that. No, I know. So why are you referring? Okay, I want to test this out, guys. We have 217 gold. We haven't got any other shops, do we? So I have... how did we get... I've forgotten how we got healing items. Okay, for 500 we can get the blacksmith going, or the forge. We got some... Okay, let's just go and test this out, because I want to see if we lose our money again when we leave the dungeon, because every time, so far we have lost both of, lost the money both times when we left this place, so that's kind of frustrating. Okay, let's try that again. Ooh, come on. Massive heart attack. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. I hope that's not, that shouldn't be something that should reoccur. You sure you shouldn't be checking in with the doctor if it's heart problems again? To see if there's something to that has to be done about it. Okay, then I think this is just this thing again. Why do your teals? Yes, okay. That's nothing new. So let's try and go to the next one. Okay. Run around. Break these. Okay. No. Don't absorb me. Ah, we got it. Okay. And let's just... it doesn't really seem to give us anything when we break these, so I don't know. I'm just kind of breaking them because I can. Where did we come from? We came from over here, I think. I have an appointment on the 29th. Okay, the 29th, that must be on Tuesday. Okay, but if you start feeling worse, then I would say it would be a good idea to maybe go and get a checkup before. Oh no, we're so gonna die. Oh no, we died. I'd rather have one checkup too many, so to speak. Okay, we still have our 200. Okay, so there's even stuff like... okay, come on, give me my stuff. So the ground might disappear underneath you. Okay, let's stand right here. Aha, then we can take you. Ooh. Okay, that might have been a bad idea. And because now we have no way of getting over there, so we can continue. Ugh, crap. Or at least I don't think there's any way of getting over there. I have no way to get anywhere right now. Wife can't drive and I'm not coherent enough to drive. Oh, but that doesn't sound good. But if it gets worse, I would say you should call an ambulance or something. Then they should be able to come and pick you up or come and check on you. There we go. Oop. Okay. Oop, oop. See if we stand right there. Oh, no. Oof. Okay. My boyfriend had a kidney stone. A couple of months ago or something now. For the first time. So, of course, the pain was ridiculous. And he doesn't have a car or anything either. So they actually came and checked on him in the evening. So he kind of called them and then they sent like a medic cart or whatever it's called. A medic wagon or car or... Not like an ambulance, but... At least the doctor came and checked on him, even though it was kind of outside normal working hours. Oh, nope. There we go. Come on. Okay, so far so good. I'm still wondering where we got those healing items from that we got the first time. Must be placed to the left or the right, that's fine. And left and right, so we can take those. And let's just take all of them. And, oh, no, stop it. Break this. Oh, what was that? I have no idea. A golem core. Okay, cool. you have a blue nose? Damn printer ink. Yeah, I must say. out of our stock, is that what they called? Okay. Yeah, it's like you call it ER or like, yeah, out of hours, some kind of place. And then usually they will ask you to come somewhere. But if you can't do it, they can come and check on you. Or if you are not able to do that, then they can come and check. At least that's how it is here. And well, in Holland too, since that's where my boyfriend lives. But I would say if it's something with the heart, then that's very important to go and get a checkup. No healing items, so do we want to continue? Oh, it does cost 200. I thought it cost 500 to use the pendant, but it's actually 200 gold. Wow. It's just because when they kind of illustrated how to use it, it looked like it was like 5 golds or something. Huh. But I still don't get why we went from 300 and something down to 20 last time, because we had 300, so it should still have like 100 something. Man, this game is confusing. Urgent care, ambulance, hospital. Yeah, works here too. Yeah, urgent care is probably what I'm thinking about. Oh. Oh boy, we're almost dead here. That's not good. Oh boy. Okay, come on. Okay, come on. Kill it. Then we should be able to get a little bit of goodies and then... Oh, is my inventory full? Oh, no, there we go. Okay. Not sure what the deal is with the stuff you can break. Okay, but we're almost dead, so I think the best thing is to see if we can find our way back out. I can't remember where we came from. Okay, this is closed. Did we come from down here? No, that doesn't look right. Maybe it's closed behind us, so we might have to use the pendant. Yeah, I think it's closed behind us, so we can't get out. Ah! Kind of expensive. Okay, but if we want to get anything out of... Oh, no! What was that about? Now it's 300 to use the pendant. And we sold some stuff. I was holding down L. And then instead of traveling, it sold some stuff. That is peculiar. Okay, and now it's more expensive. So I guess the further into the dungeon you are, the more expensive it is to use it. Okay, I'm slowly learning. I'm sat here with a hot water bottle. Why are you sitting with a hot water bottle? Are you feeling poorly again, Zoe? Oh, come on. Okay, let's just do it this way. So, let's see, we want to keep these, I think, because we need them for crafting. So let's keep you. I think this is good for crafting too. Well, I guess we just want to try and sell some stuff off that we haven't already. So let's take you. So we can figure out what the prices are for everything. So let's try and sell one of each of these items that we haven't sold before. And what else do we have? We haven't actually... Yes, we have sold some of these. So how do I put you back? L. Water sphere. I don't think I have used that. See, this was the one that was close to the 250, so I guess we're gonna have to try that. Golem core. Let's put you there. And we're gonna, well, if it's for crafting, but okay, let's just try and see if we can sell it. Because we're gonna need some money, so... Okay, and we have these. Did we ever sell? Yeah, we did sell some of them, I think. Okay, that's the idea. So let's try and go here. And I'm gonna take the gold runes, put you there. Get the empowering crystal, plant flesh, and foundry rests. Okay, so see, water lamp is close to that. Foundry rests is pretty far up there. So that's probably a higher price. Golem, what else did we put for sale? I don't really see any of the other stuff. Okay, fabric is higher than 250. So this is the only thing that's lower. Everything is higher, I think. That was this. Right, yes, foundry rest. So, I wish you could just type the... But you can't. I wish you could just type the price. So you didn't... Like, look at this. If we have to go to like 5,000 or something as a price, then you can just sit like this. That doesn't make sense. What about you? You doesn't do anything. No. I was just wondering what it was next to it. Well, I'm off to play Space Engineers for a while. Building an underground hangar base. Oh, nice. That sounds cool. Have fun with that. And I hope you'll be feeling better over the next couple of days. Yeah, I just wish I had better block shapes. I can't build what's in my head because of the limitation. Oh, that's frustrating. Are they gonna update the game with some new stuff? Later on, maybe. Okay, that was that. Then we need foundry rests. Okay, fabric is just a bit... gold runes. Ooh, okay, I can't see any of the other stuff. Okay, let's try and see. So gold runes. Oh, no. Ugh, okay, let's try that again. And then we're just gonna have to do that. I doubt it. They're discussing abandoning the game. I hope they don't. Oh, that's sad if they're... Why do they want to abandon the game? I think it's a bit of IBS. The last time I got bad, I had to go to the A&E. What is IPS? IBS? IPS? But I hope not, Zoe. Yeah, but tired of working on it. That's like a bad excuse. Well, I get it if they're not really selling enough and they have to start working full time on something else or something. Then that happens sometimes with these games, especially indie games, that they can't always afford to keep working on it. Even though I would say even if you're working full time, then even if they would just spend a few hours to, you know, every week do something, then they can still improve a game, can't they? Even though I would, but of course it depends on the state of a game, if it's worth it to even do that. What do we have to do? We have to do, some of the stuff is not actually in the golem one, so let's see if we can, find it in here. Nothing. Okay, let's try that again. See, then it goes back to the first page again. So annoying if you misclick or something. Okay, 8,000 gold. Training short sword. Oh, there we go. Let's go back up. Where did it go? I saw it. Empowering crystal. Aha, so that is higher than... Oh, it's not that much higher. It's almost the last, but then it's gone again when I try to, okay, there. Then it skips. Okay, see, now it says 21 out of 22, and then when I go back up, it skips to 20. It's kind of confusing. There's a little box like that, see? Now I'm at, should be at 22. I can't go any further. Then I go up, then it turns. Okay, anyway. So it doesn't seem like we can sell it for that much. But we still need to find the last item. Where is that hiding? A little confusing that we get items from the golem place. But... Oh, there we go. Plant flesh. High fiber count in these plants, very useful for crafting. Okay, that's higher than 60. Okay, well, let's see. So, this was said to be higher than 60, so let's try and see if my idea here works. Oh! Ah, nice! Thank you for the suggestion, Libo Cap. That really helped. Oh, that's cool. I didn't think about doing that. Awesome. Okay, let's try and set this to 70. And what do we still have left? We have this one, but that didn't seem to be that... Oh, that makes things so much easier. Oh, irritable bowel syndrome. Oh, that's annoying dealing with something like that. My dad has something similar. He has struggles with Crohn's disease or something. I think it's called in English too. Okay, let's try these prices and see if... okay, why can I not open this shop? It's almost nighttime or something, I guess. I can only go outside. But I want to open the shop. Okay, can I see the time anywhere? Not really. Said KJ. It would be nice if you had like a time so you could see what time of day it is. Inventory. We have a wish list, we have a calendar, but it doesn't really show us the time, does it? Notebook. Inventory. Room spear. Wish list. Okay, so nothing on the wish list yet. Ah, interesting. Oh yeah, you have a great day too, Lipocap. And take good care of yourself. Oh yeah, you struggle with the bladder too, that's so annoying. Having to deal with that too. It is not easy with all these health issues. Okay, so how do I know when a time has passed? Because I didn't really want to go to the dungeon, I just want to sell stuff. Okay, but you won't let me do that, you'll only let me go outside, bummer. Anything new? Nope. That's just the same stuff. Okay, well, I guess we just have to try and sell things then, now. And then we have to wait for them to, for it to be a new day, because I didn't want to go to a dungeon. So how do I, like, progress the day? Oh, can I sleep? Is that a possibility? Can I just go and sleep? Hey, I can. Nice. Okay, so new day. Awesome. Yep. And then we're gonna try and open our shop again. And see if they wanna sell any or buy any of this stuff. Oh, you're so upset. 200 was too much. Did we pick the right price for anything? Come on, guys. Oh, happy. Happy, happy. Okay, he's happy. Awesome. So, I guess we picked the right price for that one. And... okay, well, we can go over here. And then we can kind of try and... change this one. Oh, come on. Change this one. That was too much. So if we bring this down. And let's try and say 150. And let's try you. And then we're gonna go here. Oops. And bring you up. And let's just try and set it to 250 since it's close to that. And see what they say. Okay, you didn't like the price of that. Ooh, okay, that's too cheap for these. Really? Oh, okay, but I picked the right price for the lamp. Nice. It seems. What about, did I pick the right new price for those things? I have no idea. Come on, guys. You want to buy something? No. Okay, let's see. So, this was too much. So, if we bring you down, just try with 60. And then we're going to try and put you there. We're going to try and put this one. Oh, there. And let's see. Golem core. You are down there somewhere. And white stone is there. Okay, so white stone. Gonna transit you to 200. And we're gonna transit this to, oh, come on. Nope, I keep hitting the wrong button. Okay, there we go. And go up and enter and something like that. So let's see. Oh, nice. We picked the right price now. So he's willing to buy it. And what about that one? Yes. Awesome. Oh, we have 888. So we actually have enough. I think we're going to try and build the forge in a minute. Just want to see if we can get them to buy a little bit more stuff. Come on. But But it's a very slow-paced game, actually. It's I have to go and do the dungeons, and then you have to sell stuff. And I hope over time you can like increase the size of your shop so you can sell more stuff at a time. Because otherwise, you know, then... Okay, I think I said that a little too cheap. Because it's very time-consuming, this, if you have to run around and do this all the time. Okay, nice. We sold all this. So, then you kind of have to place things again. It would be kind of nice if you could just sell, place more stuff. At a time, so you didn't have to do it like this. There we go. Okay, so let's put you there. And you, I think... Oh, it's a new day. Uh-huh. But we did make something. Nice. So let's try and go back here. Where are we? There. So let's put you to 300. Then we have glass lenses and something. See, the fabric is just above 250. Glass lenses has to be lower than crystallized energy. So that's less than 100, I think. And then the water sphere. So... let's go. Oh, no. There we go. And let's set you to, let's say 80. And let's set this one to 60. And can I get them to? No, it won't let me open the shop now. It's a new day. Why won't you let me open the shop? Oh, okay. Never mind. We have enough money. Oh, yeah. I'm making a little bit of money now. There we go. Let's just try and see. So, yeah, 500, 500, 5500, and very expensive. Well, we can make Vulcan's Forge now. So if we right or enter. No, and yes, yes, I would like to build that. So let's see what's going to happen. Okay. Nice, look at that. Awesome. So we built a forge. And since we have enough money for it right now, I kind of want to do something else too. So let's do the wooden hat. Find potions and enchantments for this and that. Yes. Okay, so we have a little dude who's going to come and build something for us again. Nice. It looks like they might have a quest for us, or at least something. Okay, so. Barely any money yet left. But. Hi. You must be Will, no? The one who requested my forge. My name is Andre, Forge Master Extraordinary. If it's weapons or armor you seek, Vulcan's Forge is the place. Oh, nice. So, okay. What is this? Fabric bandana. Then we're gonna need four fabric, which we don't have. But then you can see how much you actually have, so we don't have to have it on us. That's a good thing. It registers how much we have. But then you can see it, you kind of don't want to sell everything of everything, because we're gonna need some of it for all these items. Ooh, we could make an iron helmet. I don't know why recipe sells 4,000, but we do have the iron bars and the other items. So let's see, J grab, K add to wishlist. Oh, so I can add stuff to wishlist and then maybe I can see it while in the shop what I need for it. Might be something. It gives me plus 40 health. Interesting. What else can we make? You're gonna need more steel to make a steel helmet. Fabric chest plate. You can make iron chest plate, steel chest plate, fabric boots, iron boots, and steel boots. Interesting, but there's also other stuff. So we can make a bow, for instance. We can training gloves, training spear, training big sword, training short sword. Okay, well, I think for now, Let's just try and see if we can make this. So, yay. You don't have enough gold for it. So I need 4,000 gold for the recipe, I guess. Man, we're gonna need so much money to do just a little bit of stuff. Huh. And then it looks like you can actually upgrade it. Wow, look at that. 192,000. Oh, this is so expensive. Okay, so what about this one? That's 1,000. And then 4,000 and 4,000. Man. We're gonna need so much money for this. 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. Okay, that's gonna be a while before we can do any of that. That's a lot of money that you have to make before you can actually do anything. Oh, 1 second, guys. There we go. Kind of had a little frog in my throat and needed to get something to drink. Okay, let's go and check out you. Iris, so... Oh, a customer. My apologies, it's just this book is so good. Oh, I know how that is. Okay, yes, I'm Iris, Weaver and Potion Master. Come to the Wooden Hat when you need a potion or enchantment. What do you want to craft today? Potions or enchantments? Okay, how expensive is that? So, recipe 118. Restores 40 health, should always have one or two of these on hand. Okay, this one is 379, but it doesn't really show a difference. Oh, okay, so in this case, we need to have an item available, and we have 15 of those, but it also costs us 118. Otherwise, it's 379, but then we don't need to have anything, any ingredients. Okay, then 75 health. Man, it gets expensive quickly. Look at that, 2374. 7,599. Seriously, the prices here are crazy. Okay, but we should be able to do this, so let's just try. How many do you want? Okay, how do I... No. Okay, let's try that again. I am fine. What do you want to craft today? Potions, yes. Okay, so if we have this one, let's say grab. How do I change it? Like, WASD doesn't do anything. So, how do I change how many I want? Doesn't seem like I can. Minus 5, plus 5. Required 125. Well, I guess we need 125 for each. And that's expensive. Okay, yes, let's just do that. Wow, I got one. Oh, look at that, how many you're gonna need of these to even... So much money just to get one little thing. Fresh potions and the odd enchantment are two available here. Okay, let's just check out the enchantments. Since we are at it, so nothing in there, not yet, anyway. Swords and shields, so plus 10, okay, we can enchant it, so it's plus 27 instead of plus 20. But it costs 1,000 gold to do that. And 2,000 gold to get a little bit more damage on here. Man, sorry. Wow. I have a feeling I would get the idea of starting over and then actually do the easy one where you focus on the story, because then it would be easy and you don't die as much. Just because, man, this is... You would have to... spend so much time in those dungeons and trying to sell stuff before you can get enough money to get any kind of upgrades. I'm trying to find the... Okay, I think it's up here. Oh, There we go. Yep, I wanted to check. If I want to upgrade my shop, what did we have again? Cheap sale box. Items sold in the sale box will have a 75% discount. Oh, you can choose to have that too. Iron cash register will entice customers to add an extra 10% tip when paying. We have a comfy bed that will grant extra health in the morning. And we have the small chest. What else do we have? Better beds. But it doesn't seem like you can increase how much room you have, unless that's here. Okay, this shop expansion allows merchants to decorate it. But this shop expansion adds new showcases, more decor space, and a brand new quest point so merchants can receive customer requests. That's cool, but we're gonna need 60,000 gold to do this. Wow. But it seems like you have more showcases, so we can probably sell more at a time. We can kind of see the way it's... Okay, yeah, this one already has more showcases, it seems, because it has 8 tables instead of the 4 we have now. And this one has an extra chest and 2 extra showcases. This one has another 2 extra showcases and an extra chest, and so on. But it takes so much money just to get there. Ow. Okay. Anyway, I just wanted to show you guys a little bit about a little bit of this stuff. Oh, and there's actually something over here. Okay, before we end the live stream tonight, we're just gonna check out what else he wants to say. So what do you want, since you had like a... goodbye, grab... Well, it doesn't really seem like we can do anything. I guess it's just to indicate that we can do something with him. If we have the money. We have to have the money. Because hers is gone. But it doesn't seem like we can actually do anything. With him. Interesting. Huh. Yeah, we're gonna need money before we can do that. Anyway, that is it for tonight, guys. I'm not quite sure what I think about this game. It's probably fun sometimes, but I think I would prefer to start over and do the easier one, if that lets you kind of progress a little faster. But yeah, it's a personal preference and what you think is fun in games, of course. Yeah, thank you for hanging out with me, and thank you to anyone who's gonna be watching the videos I'm gonna turn this into. So, yeah. Do take care, and as always, happy gaming!